Photo dumps are a popular type of post on Instagram where people post a bunch of photos from their past week, month, or whatever they've been up to. But photo dumps have now found their way onto TikTok and they are becoming a bigger thing all the time. There's actually tons of different trends related to photo dumps that go to different sounds, and here is the latest one.
Life is good, you know what I mean? Like, 100,000 for the cheapest ring on the finger,
little. As you can see, this trend puts together a ton of photos that someone has that they want to post, but they might not have a way to post them all on Instagram. So now they're taking 30, 50, or even more to just post as a video quickly on TikTok. So today I'm gonna show you guys how to do this specific photo dump trend using a template that I made and an online video editor so you don't have to download anything. But if you don't wanna do this exact trend and sound, you can still use a lot of this information to make your own photo dump to whatever sound you may like using the same online video editor. It'll just take you a couple more steps to upload your own sound, but the concepts are still the same. So let's get into it. Now for this specific photo dump, obviously you can see that the photos go really, really fast. So the first thing you're gonna wanna do is find quite a few photos. Between 30 and 60, I think is good, depending on how fast you want them to play and if you want to use the entire sound. So what I would do is I would just select all the photos that you want and then put them into their own album on your phone. As a tip, these photo dump trends oftentimes also use photos, not just of you, but also where you've been, what you've eaten and things like that. So you might wanna use some landscapes or pictures of food. And later I'll even show you guys how you can use stock photos super easily in just a couple of clicks so you can add some aesthetic game to your photo dumps. Also, obviously keep in mind that all of these photos have to fit nicely in vertical. So it's really helpful if all the photos are already in vertical form. And if they're not, make sure that the subject that you want to highlight is within a vertical selection. So make sure it's not too big. Okay, so now once you have all the photos in the album, the next step is to make the first frame that you see in the video, which is a screenshot of your photos app with the picture that you want to come up first as the most recent photo. So here's how you're gonna do it. You're gonna wanna find the photo that you want to start the trend with. This is the one that people will have the longest time seeing, so it's probably your favorite photo of yourself. Then you're going to want to click the share button in the bottom left, and then you're going to want to scroll down and click the duplicate button. So once you duplicate it, just go out into your albums and then take a screenshot because it should be the most recent photo. So once you have that screenshot, just put that into the same album that you have all of your other photos in. Okay, so then you're going to go ahead and send those photos to your computer. While you are able to use the online video editor Kapwing that we'll be using today on your phone, I find that it's easier to do on your computer, especially because these are really short clips. It's going to be easier to do this on your desktop. So do that if you can. So if you're going to use this exact trend that I was doing, click the first link in the description and it'll take you to the template that I made using this sound. If you don't want to use this sound or this exact template, you can either just click on the template anyway and then just start over and delete everything and start anew, or you can click the second link in the description, which will take you to the editor, which will let you start fresh. So now I'm going to hop on the computer and walk you guys through this. Okay, so when you click the first link in the description, it'll take you to the Life is Good photo dump TikTok trend template. And you can just click edit this template, and then you'll just want to wait a moment for everything to load in, and then you'll see that this is the template. So the first thing you're going to want to do is just delete all the placeholders. So that includes the images that are stock photos. And once you've read the text, you'll just want to make sure that you delete all of that as well. So the next thing you're gonna do is you need to upload all of your photos. So you're just going to go ahead and do that. I just downloaded all of them onto my computer and I just like to drag them in right into the timeline. And then you'll see it'll start uploading. It may take a few minutes for all these photos to upload. Okay, so now I have all of my photos loaded in. If you don't want to do this trend, now is a good time to delete this music, and you can upload your own. Going to the audio tab on the left here, you can either drag in to upload any audio that you have, or you can paste in a link to a video that you find online that you want the sound from. But so now what you're gonna wanna do is just highlight all of these photos. And once you do that, you should see a duration drop-down menu on the right-hand side of the screen, and you're going to click that. And if any of these durations are good for your trend, you can go ahead and click those. But because this trend is so fast, you're gonna click custom duration. And for this, depending on how many photos you have for this song, you probably want to do between 0.1 and 0.2 seconds. Okay, great. So now I have all these photos. Now you can see that they don't quite match up with the end of the audio. So you're going to want to do that. Either you can trim down the audio, or of course you can add more photos, or you can go back to the duration and increase it to a little bit more. And then you're going to place this rapid stream of photos right when the beat drops if you're doing this trend, so right around here. And you can see the beat drops when the audio just has a bigger waveform. So now you're gonna wanna upload that photo that you took of the recent picture in your Photos app and then put that at the front. And you can go ahead and resize that by dragging the corners. And you're going to want to use the split button on this first picture a few times throughout because we're about to start cropping in on this. So I split mine into 5 parts, and then I'm going to trim the end so that it ends right at the beat drop. So once you have the screenshot in, you're going to leave the first clip alone, and then the other ones, you're slowly going to start zooming in. So you can see when you have a clip highlighted, you can zoom in using this zoom slider on the right. This is probably the easiest way and the way I recommend, so just keep using the zoom slider and zoom in on the photo that you want to end up on. And then it should look a little something like this. And then you want your first photo after this to be the original photo so that you can see it kind of bleeds into the original photo once the beat drops. And now's the time to start making sure that all of your photos fit inside of the canvas. So you're just going to drag the corners of each photo and make sure that they all fit. So yeah, I'm just gonna go ahead and do that. Now, if you have a photo that you're having trouble resizing like this, because it might not be highlighting the correct portion that you want, see, it cuts both of our faces off, and let's just say that I want to be the one in it, you can click the crop button and then click the 9x16 button and then put whatever you want exactly in the frame, and then you should be good to go. You might have to do a little resizing, but that's a good way to make sure that whatever you want is exactly in the frame. Okay, so now you can see that all my pictures are in the canvas. I did delete a couple of them so I could show you an example of what to do if you either don't have enough photos or want to add like aesthetically pleasing photos. Go over to the left sidebar here and go to the images tab, and then you can just search for whatever you want. So you could say something like, if you want some beach photos, you could say beach, and then you can just click the photo and then it'll add into the timeline. Now, once again, you're gonna wanna make sure that all the photos you add are the same amount of time. So you can go down to the duration at the bottom of the edit tab and go to custom duration and change it once again. And you can do that to whatever photos that you may have. So I'm happy with this. So I'm just going to trim down the song at the end. And then I end up with a video that's like this.
Life is good.
So then when you're happy with your video, you can just click the export project button in the top right, and then you can click export as MP4. And then you have a couple options. So you can just download the file using the download file button on the right here that'll pop up once it's done processing, or you can share straight to TikTok by clicking this button, and then it'll ask you to sign into TikTok on Kapwing. You'll get a push notification on TikTok in your mobile app when you open it, and then through the push notification, it'll have the video from Kapwing that you can then post on TikTok. I would still recommend applying the trending song on the video because then this will help it get more views, and also make sure you hashtag PhotoDump because PhotoDump is trending right now on the TikTok Explore page. All right, you guys, I hope you now know how to make video photo dumps to any song, and I hope this was helpful to you. Make sure to subscribe to the channel to join an online community of modern creators, and also to keep up with other trends and tutorials that are important for creators like you. Have a good one, and I'll see you guys in the next one.